can't tell you how many events that we've missed. A movie, a quiet dinner, just even an evening at home. The beeper is always on. The radio is always on.
When do you go on vacation?
Too many lonely souls have drifted out to sea.
I understand people have financial problems. I do. I understand that plumbing is an unexpected, oftentimes unbudgeted for expense.
I don't think any customer in their right mind, as far as service plumbing, emergency service, you know, nobody wants to pay the plumber.
A lot of people don't expect to pay, you know, a couple hundred dollars to have a pipe fixed. So that I totally understand, I totally respect. What I have a problem with is people who request the service, they're quoted a price up front, and then once we solve the problem, the emergency's done, it's like, well, catch me if you can.
You lay your bets and then you pay the price.
I was over at a lady's house and I was fixing her dryer vent, so I wasn't looking at her, but then when I get up and turn around, she's bending over and her blouse is wide open and her breasts are hanging out. And she's got a video, porno videotape in her hand. And she says, you want to come watch this with me?
The things we do for love. The things we do for love. Communication is the problem to answer. You've got a number and your hand.
She was quoted in USA Today weekend section a couple of years ago, probably about 10 years ago, when she got her big $7 million contract. We all know we don't deserve as much as a great teacher, or in my mind, a great plumber. But the gratitude you have when a plumber comes quickly, when your toilet is overflowing and they're supremely talented, should be matched with dollars. Given the choice between Baryshnikov and a plumber, I would have to choose a plumber.
The things we do for love, like walking in the rain.
Why didn't you break up the floor for $2,500 and rough out the plumbing while you were there?
Well, because he didn't want us to do
it
right now.
You don't frame first.
The general contractor didn't want us to do it right now.
Some days I say why.
For you, baby.
You know, there's easier ways to make a buck.
When you're feeling like a part of you is dying.
Did Bruce tell you about the time he cut a wax ring off a toilet, or used wax ring? And he cut off the wax ring that has, you know, old fecal matter and stuff on it. Wiped it off very casually on his pants, trousers, and then he proceeded to cut open an apple that he had brought with him and then eat the apple. Yeah.
And you're looking for the answer in her eyes.
A lot of companies are trying to emulate and do what we do, but they can't.
We have a different philosophy from a lot of businesses. Bigger is not better.
Do they have a turkey club?
We like to be leaner, meaner, sleeker.
Listen, do you have a turkey club?
How to answer the telephone to increase sales, how to beat the home centers, customer complaints, making lemonade out of lemons.
Let me talk to the waitress.
How to get paid more in full, on time, at less cost, with less stress, without losing value customers. I got it. Listen to that.
I don't want the roll-up, though. Do you have, what kind of bread does it come in?
They don't want to follow him around. They want A-list people, not B.
You think you're gonna break up, then she says she wants to...
I think you'll find that if I came to your house, I would try to make you laugh a little instead of letting you be upset. I'd rather see the customer happy. So I'll say something like, you know, I'll be cleaning the sewer, and I'll say, oh, look at this, you know, I see some brown trout. Or, you know, I'll be ready to camera a sewer, and I'll say, well, let's see if you had corn last night.
We aren't here to make a buck, per se.
I'm kind of a psychologist, and a plumber.
Yes, we're here to make money, and that's the goal of any business. You need money to survive and to continue year after year and pay bills and pay employees.
I mean, I've hugged customers. We've had hugs with customers and tears on jobs. They're so broken up about their house and their belongings, or water coming through the ceiling.
We look at it as, this is a lifestyle we have of helping people and serving people and solving their problems.
I won't lie and say if I hit the lotto that I keep working. That's BS, you know. But since I don't have a choice in the matter, I have to work. I have to pay the bills. I have to pay the mortgage. Since I have to work, I love what I do.
And you can't fake that. You can't replicate that. You can try to, you can pretend to, you can do a lot of things that look the same, but you can't do it if it's not coming from the heart. Well, after all, it's just a compromise of the things we do for love, the things we do for love.
My father for making this day possible.